Hey everyone, it's Rita with Everything Homemade, and it is August 31st, 2020, and this is the last time you are going to see this beautiful garden before we take down most of the plants. And the reason is because of frost. If you take a look here, these are the cucumbers. And you can see the devastation frost can do in one night. And this is what happened yesterday, and it's only going to get worse. Where we are, we're near a river valley, and it really affects the weather, and we usually get colder than what is actually predicted on the weather network. And this is what happened when the weather network said it's +5 degrees Celsius outside, feels like 2. Well, the ground here is crispy. So, and cucumbers can't handle a bit of frost. So they're the first ones to go. So cucumbers are all done. We got a really good harvest, and I could put more effort maybe in extending the season, but really why? Our daylight is decreasing so rapidly. It is cool. I may get maybe one more gallon if I extend the season, so it's not worth the effort nor the time to do it. So I got my harvest when the going was good. Now it's time to close up the garden and start doing something else, and that is homeschooling at the moment. So what my kids are starting here, and I will join them after, is what we call stripping the tomatoes. There is tomatoes on. They're not going to be that big this year, but what we're going to do is we're going to take down the tomatoes just like Annika is doing here, filling up her pail, and then we're going to transfer those to these baskets right here and put them inside and let them ripen inside. If we get another frost, all of what we're growing here, all the tomatoes are going to be done. So if they get frost on them, they won't ripen very nice. What they're going to do is they're going to ripen and go mushy and mold. So we might as well ripen what we got in the house and make some sauces as they ripen with our suppers and eat some fresh, then lose everything that we have grown. So that is a big consideration when we're growing up north here. We can't wait. The frost actually touched the tops. Annika, can you show them the rolls on the tops there? You can see there where Annika is showing, and you can see the purple. That is frost damage. Okay, so we were very fortunate that I didn't lose the whole garden. So we're dealing with this. The beans here, I'm going to show you some frost damage too on the beans. And you can see the rolling of the leaves right there. That is frost damage. Again, not enough to kill the beans, but enough where we're going to strip them. And they're not flowering anymore, so whatever we get, we'll eat the beans for supper. You can also see the damage on the pumpkin plants right there. And you can see that throughout. Again, they were able to survive a lot better than the cucumbers did. So I'm going to show you, we're harvesting all pumpkins. And I'm going to go over that a little more in detail in a moment. Good job, buddy.
Thank you.
So what we're going to do is we take all the plants, we're just going to put them in a big pile for now, and then dispose of them later. So we got a lot of work. We got Grace there with little Meadow. We got Ocean there, Annika, and then Nova on this end here. And I'll be somewhere around here after. Okay, so let's just take a little bit of a look here at the moment. The corn surprisingly did good. I was actually a bit shocked to see very little damage. The corn is not ready to harvest, so we are actually going to just take our chances. It's not ready, so you're not going to get anything by taking the ears off early, so we don't know what we're going to get here with the corn. The carrots actually are sweeter as the weather gets cooler. So carrots, I am not even worried. Even if we get a bit of snow on top of them, I am still not worried because the carrot root themselves are in the dirt. And I have harvested carrots when the ground was beginning to freeze. So I'm not worried at all with the carrots. If you have lettuce or Swiss chard at this time, no big deal. It can totally handle it. The broccoli, the kale, the cabbage stuff, that all can handle a bit of frost. No big deal there. The zucchini is completely done with, but we had harvested everything beforehand. I'm gonna try my hand at zucchini relish this year, see how it turns out. The butternut squash is totally done. I mean, it's no point. We got frost damage here. The next time it freezes, it's gone. And I had one comment from a subscriber that I will try next year that maybe I should have thought of, but you know what, with all the busyness, sometimes you just don't think of everything, is I maybe should have hacked it back a bit to stimulate more butternut squash to come, but that's not what I did. It was already late, but I do see that we were starting to get little squashes right there just at the end of the season. So I'm not going to pull this plant out quite yet. I'm going to really wait to the bitter end to see if this little squash can at least grow to half decent size, even if it doesn't completely mature, just to taste it. So I'm just going to leave this in. It's not going to hurt anything just to try. But if we were like 3 weeks early, if the seeds didn't take so long, I am going to try butternut squash again, because let me tell you, if you fail, what do? You get back up and you try it a different way. That's how you succeed. And as a gardener, you gotta look at failure as a way to learn and a way to grow and not a way to stop. Because you only fail when you stop trying. So, we're gonna keep trying that. Okay, what else can I show you? So let's take a look at the peas for a moment, and they are crispy, aren't they? Yeah. So Nova, gently grab a pod off and then come a little closer to my camera.
They're harder than I thought to break.
Yeah, just pull it off. So what I want you to do is just open it up. And show them what the peas look inside. And that's exactly, just hold it still right there. Awesome. So you see the shrivelness of them? They kind of resemble raisins.
Yeah.
That kind of the shrivelness of them. That's exactly what you want. These are dried peas and they're ready for storage. So we're gonna pick the peas. We're gonna store them. You can store it in a baggie. I've stored them in envelopes. I've stored them in wax paper made envelopes. As long as you store them somehow in something, and then I put it into like a plastic box with all my seeds and into a cold storage, so a cooler room. I've had saved seeds for years in cold storage.
What if they get wet?
Then they're ruined. So you don't want any moisture to get to them, because moisture makes them sprout. It can also make them mold and rot, right?
Yeah.
So this is what we want to see. These are now peas ready to be grown for next year. So we're definitely going to be working on that. Now let's learn some things on how to harvest the pumpkins, and you can take this advice with any kind of squash that you want to bring inside the house. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start cutting these off. Now you need something that will cut good, because these are strong, and I'm just going to simply, I'm just going to take this leaf out of the way so you can see what I'm doing. I'm just going to trim the top off here. I'm just going to trim the top, so I leave about an inch, and I'm just going to cut them off. And then I'm just going to stack them on my racks here for now. as I go. So let's do another one here. There's this big one. Whoa, look at this. So let's look at the pumpkin here. And to show you, I am just going to, because we're not saving the plants, so I'm just going to rip at these vines a little bit more. And look at this. Look at this guy. Beautiful, isn't it? Take a look at that. Absolutely gorgeous. And it is starting to ripen. You can see the lines here, which tells me that it is ripening. So it's a good time to harvest it. If you weren't going to take down your plants, you could harvest this pumpkin, harden it off, and then use it. Okay, so I'm going to add this one over here. And I'm going to keep going and harvesting. So let's see how many pumpkins we got. Take a look. Isn't that just absolutely beautiful? So the ones that are bright orange, those are the ones I'm going to be saving seed from. One, because they matured on the vine and I know that they hit maturity. And so those I'm gonna save seed, and I'm gonna show you how to save seed from your pumpkins. And again, you can use this same technique for any kind of squash and zucchini and go from there. So right now I'm gonna talk a little bit about hardening off. So Ocean, why don't you come here, please? You are going to help demonstrate for me. Okay. So what I want you to do is I want you to grab a pumpkin there. Sure, grab one of the orange ones. Now, I want you to make a nail impression right here. How easy it is to do it. Okay, you saw that? Very little effort she had to do to make that impression on that pumpkin. And she doesn't even have
nails.
She doesn't have nails. They're trimmed. And so it didn't take much. And you can tell that this outer layer here, is actually soft, okay? And so what you want to do, if you want to store these for a long time, what you want to do is put them in the sun for about a week-ish, a week to 2 weeks, depending on the weather. The hotter the weather, the faster this process will go. What it'll do, it'll start drying up this stem. And what you can do is after that period, in a different spot, just take your nail. Now, you're not pressing in like that. You're just taking your nail and just going down it. It should be hard to make a nail impression. Then you know it's hardened off properly. And it's as simple as that. And it has worked on my spaghetti squash year after year. And in this case, is that your little baby Ocean?
No, it's hard holding it out here. It's heavier. It's okay. Easier this way.
So as she hugs her pumpkin, we are not going to harden these off. Now, I'm going to make these into pumpkin pie filling, and I haven't decided whether I'm going to can it yet or whether I'm going to just freeze the filling. I'll decide when I make it, but I'm going to show you how to process these pumpkins. Because I don't want to be bothered with cutting open the pumpkin 3 or 4 months later for pumpkin pie. I want to have the filling already made. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to show you that in a different video. Because right now I started schooling today. So I'm going to get back to these pumpkins on the weekend. I'm just going to take them and put them in a basket. Put them downstairs in the furnace room for now and just forget about them until the weekend. As for the plants, we're going to see what critter likes to eat these plants and clean everything right up. The black plastic that you see underneath, right? We put black plastic underneath here. All the plastic we're going to take up, we're going to place it on the lawn to dry, and then we're going to fold it up to be reused for next year. Always try to reuse as much as you possibly can. Same with the cucumbers over there. There's that black plastic underneath them. We're going to take that black plastic. We're going to lay it on the lawn to dry. We're going to take the white or clear plastic that we use to cover the cucumbers, and we are going to hang it up to dry. And then, does your hand smell like tomatoes, Nova?
Yeah.
They also look like tomatoes.
Yeah, so we are going to smell like tomatoes after we're done, aren't we?
Dad's going to come home and imagine. Did you guys eat a lot of tomatoes or something?
So we're going to keep all the plastic and reuse it for the following year. Other than that, we're just going to continue stripping the garden. And there's one other thing I do want to show you. Ocean, remember I showed you and talked to you about these marigolds?
Yes.
So let's show them what we're looking at here, because I have no more seed of these marigolds. And I want to save seed. Now, when you first look at all these marigolds, you're going, well, I don't see anything shriveling up, and I don't see how you can save seed from them. But you need to look a little closer. So, Ocean, I want you to just continue doing that. So point with your fingers so they can see what we're looking at here. So as you open up the plant, you can see shriveled up dun flowers. Now I want you to pick that whole thing up and come a little closer here. Okay, so that is a dun bud. So what Ocean's going to do is pinch the top and pull. Okay, there are the seeds. So that's what we're going to harvest. So we're going to open up the plant and we are going to harvest these beautiful seeds right here. Okay, so we are actually going to wait a little bit longer. You see how a little bit yellowish and some look greenish? I'm going to wait one more week. Now, the marigolds can handle frost to a certain point. So I'm going to wait one more week, and then we're going to harvest these. And these are going to be seeds for next year. It is that simple to save. So we love this variety, and we're definitely going to continue to harvest it. And if you are interested in this particular variety of marigold, there is cygnet marigold. They're an old-fashioned marigold. They have a delightful smell, and the bees go crazy over them. Absolutely crazy. And they brought a lot of bees to my garden. And that's the whole point. Gardening is not just about me, it's also about feeding the helpful insects and bugs that pollinate and make the garden possible to have fruit. So, everybody! Hey, you got some tomatoes! Let's see! Look at those! Look at those! Okay, Annika, head over beside them there so they can see you too. Okay, everyone! This is going to be one of the last times that I film in the garden. We have a message for you.
Thank you for gardening with us.
So we really appreciate the support, the comments, the new subscribers. I appreciate all the awesome ideas. And I also feel like I did my part with the whole COVID business to really help others succeed in their gardening, especially so many that have had their first gardens, and then all the other gardeners that already know about gardening. It has just been absolutely a phenomenal year to share my garden with you. We're going to have a couple of other episodes, but there's not going to be many, and we're going to conclude the gardening series right away, and then we're going to start something new for the winter, and I have something special in store for you that I think you're going to really, really like. So stay tuned for that. Otherwise, if you don't see me posting weekly, I might go down to every second week. It is because I am homeschooling and I am dedicating 6 to 8 hours of my day in teaching my children, and that is high priority, and then everything else will come. So it's a very busy time, but it is just a change in season from September to April that we do homeschooling. So you're going to see a lot more cooking on the channel. You're going to see a little bit less gardening, but you're going to see a bit of gardening with a twist. And you are going to see some more of my kids in the kitchen and myself as we go into the winter here. And we're stuck inside schooling, aren't we, Nova?
Yeah.
Look at those beauties. Some are pretty good size and some were starting to turn.
Like that one.
Weren't they? Yep. Look at that. That one was starting to turn.
Thank you for gardening with us.